the children that are out here, are they safe while this bear?
They're reasonably safe.
Wow, a big trap for a big problem tonight. How wildlife officials are trying to catch a bear spotted wandering around several Greenville County schools. Good evening. I'm Nigel Robertson.
And I'm Gabrielle Komorowski. Wildlife officials say there have been three separate bear cub sightings between Monday and Wednesday, and they believe it's the same bear. They all happened in Greenville County near the campuses of Thomas E. Kearns Elementary, Southside High Academy, and M.T. Anderson Support Center off of Whitehorse Road and Interstate 85.
News 4's Kim Quintero got an exclusive look as wildlife officials searched the area. First of all, Kim, reasonably safe, and how do they catch a bear?
Well, apparently with a large cage-like trap, some sardines, and of all things, honey buns.
This is just a fact of life in the upper state of South Carolina. We do have bears.
Tom Swingham is a man on a mission.
Go back a little bit more. Try to get it level as we can.
The regional wildlife coordinator from the Department of Natural Resources wants to trap a bear like the one seen here that prompted three Greenville County schools to lock down Tuesday, forced an early dismissal Wednesday, and has parents on edge.
Well, hopefully they can find it and capture it and put it where it belongs.
Chantel Hunter's son attends Southside High Academy, one of the schools where the cub was spotted.
I mean, yeah, I'm concerned for everybody's children, not just my own, you know. I just hope that if it is out here, it's not dangerous.
It's a small bear. It's probably not much of a danger, but we have set two traps just to make sure.
Swingham and his team are relying on the bear's appetite to lead it to this field.
Bears have very good sense of smell, and we have sardines and honey buns as bait in there, and they're in a sack.
So the idea is the bear is going to go inside of this trap, latch onto that bag of food, and this door is going to swing shut, trapping him inside.
The trap closes slowly to be safe around children, and that's what we use in populated areas.
So far this season, two other bears were caught after roaming out of the Greenville County mountains.
The big thing people can do to minimize any problems with bears is to have no foodstuffs around their house that bears can smell and get to. That includes pet food outside, trash that they can get into.
And after a long winter's hibernation, other hungry bears are likely to follow their noses and into urban areas.
And on average, DNR officials get about 200 calls a year for upstate bear sightings, especially during the springtime. So if you spot a bear in your neighborhood, the DNR would like to hear from you.
All right, Kim, thank you very much.